The vast majority of new cases are household contacts of existing ones, but there has been transmission at four workplaces under level four, and that's causing concern. Katie Bradford has more details.
When this Christchurch mechanic opens on Wednesday, safety will be the priority. Customers aren't allowed on site and staff will have to declare they've had no contact with COVID-19.
So the office staff and the workshop staff will be in separate areas, and that means separate break times and lunches and so just so that they keep all safe. They'll have a set of clothes that they wear during work hours and then get changed and go home with another set of clothes.
The infectiousness of Delta has changed everything.
We're going to be more stringent to make sure that the procedures that we've got in place are actually ahead to.
At least 73 of the current cases are essential workers, and the virus has been transmitted in at least four workplaces, and that's got the government very worried.
This may not be a problem with the rules, say, on the factory floor, but what is happening perhaps before and after shifts or even during break times.
Far more essential workplaces are operating this level four than last time. The concern is some may be pushing the rules a bit too far.
If we get evidence to show we need to tighten things up, we will.
We need to be even more careful today. And anybody that doesn't absolutely need to be in the workplace shouldn't be in the workplace.
He accepts some businesses may be told to close or tighten up practices.
As long as they're clearly based on health and safety issues and they're not arbitrary, then I think that their businesses will understand.
Over a million people are expected to be back at work when most of the country moves to level three. Construction and manufacturing among the big industries back on the tools, and expect to see those long lines at fast food outlets. Unions worried about workers and customers.
Employers need to be doing a new risk assessment for going down to level three. Delta is a different risk, and if your employer hasn't engaged with you, that would be a concern.
No doubt about it, level three will look different this time.
Use of masks in the workplace and really maintaining that distance at 2 metres wherever possible.
It certainly won't be business as usual for some time yet.
And Katie's with us live now. Katie, the government clearly worried, seems like some of the public too. Authorities have had a number of complaints about businesses since lockdown began.
Yes, well, police have had over 3,500 complaints about businesses operating, and MB, the government agency, has had about 200 of those referred to them. I've also had unions telling me they're worried about businesses, about employers' safety in some workplaces as well. So there is a lot of concern out there. As we heard from the Prime Minister today, they're also even more concerned about what happens when most of the country moves to level three. The idea of workers moving between level four and level three is something they simply don't want to see happen. Now, applications opened today for exemptions for businesses who are in that position, who need to cross that border. But it's very clear that the criteria will be very strict on that, and people who perhaps were given exemptions last time won't be able to. There's going to be issues as well around the fact that there may be a lot of businesses who can operate under level three, but are reliant on businesses here in Auckland or Northland under level four and won't be able to get goods or trade or do the various things they may be able to do. While there are groups working with the government to try and sort that out, I think the clear message from the government is that things will be a lot tougher. Don't expect it just because you've had permission in the past. Don't expect it to happen this time. Things may be tougher than they were. Some businesses may have to close down some operations. And it's all because, as we keep hearing, Delta has changed everything. Thank you, Simon.
Kia ora, Katie. In Tamaki Makaurau, Katie Bradford.